Okay. Yeah, we're recording. Alrighty. That was a lot of deleting. Okay, this... So, my camera was actually needing to be deleted of a lot of stuff, so... And I don't have another SD card currently. Actually, I kind of wish I had all the SD cards I have invested in. If I did, buy all the cameras that I've had that have also gotten stolen, along with a lot of my videos. I wouldn't be worried about deleting anything. Just throw in another card. But I'm broke right now, so I can't help it anyways. Anyway, I'm wasting time now. We're wasting time. So, I forgot exactly which one I was on. I've actually been trying to delete stuff for a while and get stuff out. Okay. So, a sinful man thinks of sinful things, and a righteous man thinks of righteous things. So, here's a trick that happens a lot, and a lot of us think that it's, these thoughts are ours when they're not. So, okay, the enemy will try and get you to think thoughts that are not yours, to be yours, as well as remind you of your past. It's not just to get you to feel shameful and condemned, or think the Lord don't want anything to do with you. It's to try and get you to think of bad things. He will sit there and accuse us of our past. Then he will try and get us to compare our wrongs with his. You are what you think. You are... Don't just remain who you see yourself as, but the very things you think on or of. Pretty cool. So, that should take a little bit of caution to some people that should understand. One of the tricks that the enemy tries to pull on you is to not only get you to think on the negative thoughts he's throwing at you, he wants you to think they're yours. And that is only when he can get you to think they're yours, a lot of times you will think on them because you actually think they're yours. And you'll start condemning yourself, and the only thing the enemy has to do at that point is sit back and just watch you twirl down the drain. And that's one of his tricks. I didn't say the guy was freaking awesome. I said he was a prick. No, he's not a guy. He's a fallen demon piece of crap. That's a good thing that he is not going to heaven. Anyway. So. I know this is not quite me talking about what happened through my trials, and I understand that a lot of what I'm actually talking about here is more towards tricks and schemes pulled and ways to deal with it and ways to get around it. And yeah, I understand that a lot of people end up going out there, end up getting the Lord, asking in their heart, and don't even have a fighting chance with what they're walking out of because nobody helps them. You know, a lot of people end up going and doing this on their own, and the Lord never made us to be doing it on our own. And that's another thing you gotta watch out for, is the spirit of separation and offense. I mentioned something before about separation, the spirit of separation, and I also mentioned about the aspect that the enemy does not want you married. You actually see that the enemy actually tries to destroy marriages. Marriage is sacred, and marriage is awesome. But the enemy hates marriage, and he hates relationships, actually. If he can throw in some chaos in there and get you to just beat each other up, causing more wounds between you two, he will try. He will try doing that. You can think of it as the little piece of shit that comes, points in. Well, this is probably not the most happiest example, but imagine like someone coming in like your relationship that turns around and tries to steal your partner away. So he turns around and manipulates and does all of the screwed up stuff and then points the finger back at you. Or imagine the little brother or sister that does that. That's basically what it is. And he tries to do that between you and the Lord too. But he tries to make you feel or think that the Lord's not there for you, and the Lord's done all this, and the Lord's done all that. And I always accuse the Lord of what he hasn't done, not what he's done. So, well, he'll try and accuse the Lord of doing stuff that he's supposedly done. That's not good, but here's the thing, the Lord's always good. So, when we remember that and we realize that, it's like, oh, okay. Not only is the Lord good, the Lord is good. So when you actually are looking at something that's really actually good, you're really actually looking at the Lord. Did you know that? That's pretty cool. Okay. Seeking proof from the Lord for faith is the poison of faith. Okay. Holding faith from the Lord for something he has not done nails our faith to the cross as if it were a sin. If you start your day with a prayer, let it be, I just want to be thankful. You can't love or be thankful to someone who don't exist. Recite a letter of love he gave to you and invite him in your day. So, if seeking proof from the Lord for faith is actually poisoning your faith, it's because we're actually demanding him to show us proof that he is who he is. Not only that, but when he actually goes and shows us proof of something, it's never good enough. And it just starts poisoning more and more. That's one other reason why the Pharisees, they demanded proof, because unbelief demands proof. So, when he's turned around and said that the only sign they would get was the sign of Jonah. And that was getting swallowed up by a whale. You know what? When you actually think about that, it's probably not something you really want to prove. Because by then, it's pretty much too late. That sign was too late. So, anyway. A lot of times when we turn around and we're actually asking for proof for that faith, it's because we actually have an area we actually already believe, and we're actually holding that back, and we're actually taking that away from the Lord being able to have to do anything with. Basically, we're taking that and we're limiting him and trying to control him. Which doesn't work, you know. It's not a very good idea to try and control God. It doesn't work. I know this because I've tried. I'm sure a lot of us tried. Sorry, Daddy. Okay, so. Okay, for those of you that remember that one video, I was talking about authority. I'm stopping this video because I'm going on this, and I'm pretty sure I've used it most of the time anyway. Let me check. Yes, I did.